18 inches high or something stupid like that. But yesterday, it's been raining out here in southern New Hampshire, and been having a hard time with my garden and even trying to get into the pool. So maybe some of you guys saw my little pool heater video. I thought that I would try that yesterday with some coal, as opposed to, you know, yard scrap, you know, shavings from around the lawnmower and the trees that bust down. That was about 2:30 yesterday afternoon. And I dumped about 15 pounds of coal into this thing after I started a wood fire. And of course, I started a wood fire like the same way I always do, you know, maybe a couple of milk cartons with the wax on them. They go up real good and get the fire going. And I just thought that I would show you that 2:30 after yesterday afternoon. 4:30 this morning, I got up and this thing was still cooking. So I guess I will show you. Hopefully you guys can see that. It says about 370, okay, at the bottom with whatever's left in the coal box. And then as the higher up you go, 270, I don't know if we're reading this here on tape or what. And then the pipe has got no smoke coming out of it. And it's only at 80 degrees, something like this here. Okay, it's 100, 108, okay. So let me just show you inside this firebox. It's really, I'm flabbergasted. I'm brand new to running coal stoves, and I can't even believe it. This was supposed to go in my house, but it's never going to go in the house because it's a chicken brooder. And hopefully you guys are actually seeing that in there. That is what is left of like 15 or 20 pounds of coal in my first experiment. And so I thought I would show you this. It is a chicken brooder. For you guys that don't know what a chicken brooder is, that's, you know, after the eggs hatch on your poultry farm there, you got to keep them between 85 and 95 degrees for like 6 weeks. And so there should have been a big, like, umbrella-looking thing around this. Then the chicks would hang out underneath there and be able to find heat and, you know, whatever, hang out for their 6 weeks until they're big enough to take the regular weather. So that's what this little stove is. And it is tiny. As a matter of fact, I could throw that stove right into Bertha over here, the cannon number 20. This thing is huge. And judging by what I noticed yesterday, I probably would have been able to get maybe, you know, almost a 50-pound bag into that thing. It started raining yesterday, so I decided that I would, I kung fu grip on this thing here with some welding gloves and dragged it in here on the floor into the garage. And there is no smoke. And there's my garage door, and there is no heat coming out of this. I can stick my hand right in there. Okay. And it's still almost 400 degrees after, well, I don't know, it's probably 9:30 in the morning. So however many hours that is, about 19 hours on 20 pounds of coal, okay? Cost the little mechanism is all wrecked down there on that, so I just been doing it on manual. So the only drafting I got is that little opening there and whatever, you know, funkadoodle holes are open here. But yeah. And if I wasn't such a noob at 4:30 this morning, I would have just been able to drop some more coal in there. This is nut coal, or chestnut coal is what I put in there. And there's the sweepings. I swept it out into the driveway this morning. It's been raining and it looks like it just stopped. So thanks you guys for watching. If anybody is thinking about an alternative, pellet stoves are great, but you got to have electricity. And maybe one of these days I will come up with an idea. I think I have one to make those work without electricity. And it throws away all of the electronic gadgetry, which is why I don't want one of those. I'm not going to have a problem in a snowstorm with some little, you know, PC board that, you know, $200-$300, and I can't get one. I can't have one. I'm not having that problem. So we are looking for options for heating the house, and anybody else who is, you know, all the old stories of coal being dirty and what all like that is, there's no more ash out of that thing than comes out of my wood stove on any day of the week. But I would have already had to probably 100 pounds of wood into that stove to keep it going near 9 hours. It's just, there's no comparison. No comparison. And just so if you guys want to see the size here, it's ka-huge. Ka-huge. Simple as that. So, thanks for watching, you guys.